Hey everyone, it's Monica. Thanks so much for tuning in today. So you are joining here for part 3 of the ODS information series. Specifically, we will be talking about the tests that you are expected to pass during your 5-week program. So I want to mention that general information about ODS can be found directly on their website. I'll put that link down below in the description box. And if you'd like to see part 1 and 2 of my ODS series, you can also find those down there as well. So check this out. One of the very first things that we did when we got to ODS was get our measurements done. If you get weighed and you are in the proper category, then you're good. So obviously as humans, we don't come in a one size fits all body category. So if your weight is outside the range, then they'll do a second sort of measurement where they measure basically your waistline and see if you fit in that standard. So if you fail these measurements, you're just gonna be placed on FEP, which is the Fitness Enhancement Program. It's just an extra round of PT every day. So it's not a huge deal or anything like that. And its ultimate goal is to help you improve your overall health, because now we are part of the Navy and we have to, you know, uphold certain physical readiness standards. So you are gonna be extra fit by the end of 5 weeks. All right, well, let's move on to the actual PRT, or the physical readiness test. So in the beginning of ODS, you're gonna be doing a mock PRT. There's no need to stress about this or cheat. It's just to purely see where you are starting at. And then at the end of ODS, you'll be actually doing the real PRT, which goes into your records. And then hopefully by then you'll see that the trend is that you have improved all your scores. The PRT has 3 sections comprising of the sit-ups, push-ups, and a 1.5-mile run. Again, check the links down below if you want to see what you need to make based on your age and sex category, and then what scores you can get from that. So you want to shoot for at least above satisfactory, or else you'll be placed on FEP as well. And apparently, if you get an overall average of an excellent low, you only have to take it once a year versus 2 times a year. The next test is the swim test. Don't swim like this, okay? Anyways, the good thing about this is that you only have to take it once and pass, and you never have to take it again in your Navy career. The video down below will actually demonstrate the specific test that you must pass, but very briefly, you will be tested on a 10-foot platform jump, a 5-minute float, a 50-yard swim, and a clothing inflation survival test. So expect a uniform inspection. We only had one in our khakis. So basically, you're gonna present yourself in full uniform. That means, ladies, you have to have your hair, you know, slick back and a nice bun. You can put on some modest makeup finally, and your uniform has to be, you know, in tip-top shape, nicely ironed. So during uniform inspections, the chief, or the senior chief, they're pretty much going to be in your face, measuring out to the nearest inch of where your proper pins and your name tag and your insignias are. Now, you're at full attention, and they can ask you pretty much anything on the PDF. Well, at this very moment, as I'm editing, I just realized, wow, I am missing a crucial video clip. This was actually one of my very first ones in which I highly recommended that before you come to ODS, that you memorize the PDF, which is referring to the Sailor's Knowledge. I posted this link to that as well in the description box. So during uniform inspection, they can ask you to recite anything from this document. For instance, if they ask you, what is the 10th general order of the century? You have to be able to say, Chief, the 10th general order of the century is to salute all officers in all colors in standards not cased. They're probably not going to ask you to sing Anchors Away though, so don't worry about that. But if you can memorize this, it'll make life a lot easier. And yeah, so now back to the video. It's all fair game. So you have to be able to kind of spit that out verbatim without messing up too much. But the key is confidence. A really great app that I recommend is called My Navy Uniforms. It is just a really awesome app that shows you the specifics on what you can wear, where to place things. So it was a good reference. Also, we had some priors in our class that were such a great source of help. They were amazing. They showed us how to iron, just tips and tricks. So make sure you talk to your shipmates about it too. Rib inspections are a thing. They can happen at any time. It's random. And basically you want to make sure that your bed is made every single morning before you leave. That means no wrinkles in the sheets. They have to be folded a certain way, hospital corners, tucked very neatly. You can't have personal information in your drawers on the desk. You always want to put those in your locked dressers. They will strike at random, so make sure that your room is very clean and in tip-top shape before you leave in the morning, or else don't be surprised when you come back and your bed's flipped over, your drawers are all pulled out, your chair's somewhere in the hallway. That means you done failed. There's one final exam at the end of ODS, which basically tests you on the knowledge that you've gained through all the lectures through the 5 weeks. So it's generally around 50 multiple choice questions that you take on the computer, and I believe it was like a 70 or 75% to pass. Our class leaders set up an overview just to help us out, but overall it really isn't something to stress or fret about or lose sleep over. It was a pretty basic exam, and if you could get through med school or dental school or pharmacy school or whatever other school or college, honestly it really wasn't anything compared to those, so don't freak out too much. Lastly, there are two evolutions that you will be expected to pass, and I'm not going to go into much detail because it's not listed as public information on the ODS website, and I don't really want to spoil it for you. They were pretty interesting and fun and sort of stressful experiences, but it was overall really cool. Let's just say that one gets very hot and the other one will get you very soaked. So, good luck! Okay guys, so those are the main things that you will be tested on and will be expected to pass before you graduate ODS. I know it might feel a little overwhelming at the moment, but remember, this is over a course of 5 weeks. And remember, everyone is literally going to be on the same boat, rather same ship as you. See what I did there? Haha! I'd say that if you haven't already, just start picking up some active exercises that you enjoy and start reading that Navy Gouge sheet before you head over to ODS. Lastly, make sure you try to go in with an open mind. It's gonna be a different experience. There are some times that are gonna be pretty challenging mentally, physically, emotionally. I promise the 5 weeks it's gonna go by super quick, especially after week one and two, and then when you start getting those special liberties to go off base and hang out with your friends. And this is coming from someone that had zero military background, didn't have any knowledge or didn't know about the culture, and I'm still learning to this day. But it was just a really great experience. Not to mention, you are going to be the fittest that you've ever been, probably in your life. So hello to that summer bod of yours. It's just hiding below all the cushion, like me. If there's something that I didn't quite cover or you have more questions about that I need to clarify, don't be shy. Drop your comment down below, or you can always hit me on Insta and I will be more than happy to help you guys out. So in the meantime, make sure you're staying safe, stay healthy, and as always, stay flossy.